glory and honor that we are here this morning in the land of the living. We are here to give praise for all the things you have done for us throughout the years that we have brought these schools at this point. We ask you to bless us all. Fill our hearts with your love and peace. Strengthen our wills, Lord, that we will recognize that you are the Lord and the Savior, and that nothing has been impossible without you. We just ask you to touch parents, Lord Jesus. Give them the grace and the wisdom to guide the children as they go on the next step of their journey, secondary school education. Give them that wisdom to guide their daughters. And give them girls, Lord Jesus, the spirit of obedience, that they will remember what they have lived and the foundation, that you are the core of their life. Father, we praise you and we thank you, and we ask you to bless all that is with you, all of today's proceedings, that the memories formed will be forever etched in our minds, and we can give praise and glory to your name. Thank you, Lord Jesus, and we just ask you to fill this place with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Daniela, can I put on?
It has impacted our society. Many of us are parents, they are also victims. Many of them still are trying to get back to that place. But my mother always says, necessity brings riches, because you have to use your creativity now to find a strategy. And if we find a strategy, especially with some of us who have no devices, and some of our parents here who need devices. So I'm going to give your parents a clap. Because they did it all their tools, many of them did it all things to make sure that you prepared for online class. Our education system, it impacted the most, because they now realize that to do this online teaching, they had to have the money and they could not reach. So some of our goals to accept. Some of us, internet is useless. Can I say this? Every minute we are getting down to open class, frustration, parents frustrated. We frustrated. Sometimes we couldn't even contact somebody because none of our devices were working. But we are not. We are glad to see. You all came out. You are resilient. I want to thank our guidance officer, Social Doc, who was always here. Some of us mentally portrayed his natural. And we felt frustrated. And I was no one. But God sent the support personnel. We had school supervisors supporting us. We had our library manager who is always matching the course with us. She was in the case, here's what to do. We are keeping the word in prayer. We also have assistance from church. We have Dr. Walker saying, see, this anything you want me, I am going to support you. And really, so parents really supported us. So give them a clap again. So we have a drastic shift from physical school to online school. And some of you have navigated the technology better than us. Isn't that so? Until when this teacher you text in and you watch the video not focusing on this, isn't that so? So it has its positivity and it has its negativity, distraction. So right now we have to, and we are apologizing for what took place, but we are not apologizing for resilience. We are not apologizing for teaching God to hope despite what, for giving you hope, because for some of us it's not going to be hopeless. Some parents say this, you see this technology thing, and you will be able to assist your parents. So please give me a sense of that. And I want to thank the teachers to talk about that. And with this time, we have to communicate with our parents. So parents have to listen. Communication, technology is here to stay. We need your help. Those of you who tech savvy can help us. We have to communicate. We have to tell you, okay, what platform are we using, whether it's YouTube, whether it's Google Classroom. Some people use Emodo. So we have to get away from that and start selling group WhatsApp all the time because that doesn't keep it. And you will be here with us. So when you have a plan, this is for life. You have a plan, you write it down, you discuss it, you come up with strategies to get it done. And you must complete your plans, and that's what we did. So we got support from all of the parents. So when we do that, we have to trust and believe that whatever we have planned, it will work. So girls, again, I would like to thank all of you. I'm going to distribute this support to you. And it's taken from Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans for peace and sons to give the time of welfare, and not for evil, to give your future for your hope. So to my beautiful girls, God has given you the grace, and God says his grace is sufficient for you. His grace is sufficient for me. His grace even is sufficient for your parents. And by his grace, we were resilient during these times. I commend you for this. Your journey has just begun. As we transition from primary school to secondary school, you will need to be strengthened spiritually, strengthening physically, strengthening emotionally. And where does our spiritual strength come from? You need a certain discipline. And you will have to, especially our parents who are working in the protective service. They must have a discipline. Their attitudes must be disciplined. Their mindset must be disciplined. And if you want to make it, you must be what? What's the word? But I can't tell you. What you must be?
Discipline.
So you need to be spiritually disciplined. You need to read your Bible. You need to be in church. And some of you, many of you can't sit in church. That's the only way how you will know, and that's the only way how you will know. As the Samuel said just now, can be nothing about God. It is God who will give us every single thing that we need. Because this body won't be able to shut down, you know that? This body must be balanced. So you must be spiritually strengthened in mind. God is going to have what you call distractions and attacks. And you need to be strong to stand up and protect your team. And in our society, we are having that IU, integrity. Doing what is right when you do what is wrong. So hear the voice of your parents as you go along with mommy, be pleased. And MFA is between you and God. With God, be pleased with my actions, with who am I aligning with, my thoughts. Are they going to be pleased with that? So if you spend a lot of time on that self-belief, what was going to happen? Time will just pass by, and you will complete your assignments on time. When you go to secondary school, you are not going to have one teacher, as Mr. Mamalam rightfully says. You are about 13 subjects with 13 different teachers, and each teacher has an assignment, and you will get a timetable. And they don't want to hear that you didn't complete. So when you get that timetable, give it to the parents as well. Say, mommy, Have me to keep my track of my work or die, or whoever takes care of me. That teaches you time management. So write your name down, put it down, and you're going to execute what you need to do. So you need to pray every day. Don't forget to pray, because God will forget the way you are made. So pray. You need to be mentally strong. Say positive things. Your words, you know your words are right, right? Yes. So if I go into child like that, you are ready for the blood. So whatever comes in mathematics, you will not receive it. When you have a positive attitude, you will receive and you will touch. Negativity kills that and brings stagnation. So please, girls, positivity. Physical. So you're going to go into school. Some of us, for the 2 years, we didn't know formal exercises in that school. So some of us, I went, our girls came out of school when we had PE, was drama, and that coordination skills. Some of them can't skip. They can't do that ball, they can't do anything. So we, parents, you have to do that too. Let them get physically active so that oxygen can go to the brain so that they can be healthy girls. Girls, you have to eat healthy. Especially during our adolescent years, this is where it comes back on, especially when we like to eat snacks and not eat our food. So watch that. So you need to be spiritually healthy and spiritually disciplined, mentally disciplined, and physically disciplined. So this. And this is what's lacking in our homes, it's lacking in society. Respect. You cannot act with your parents and bring them to different paths. That's wrong. Learn to respect your parents. Give them what is due unto them. And listen. Obedience brings what? Tell your parents what does obedience bring? When they can't change, what does obedience bring?
Blessing.
Say no, obedience brings?
Blessing.
You want to live a blessed life, my girls? I want you to live a blessed life. So respect your parents, respect Rani. Respect. And it goes along with you. So girls, you will be moving on, and I'm happy for all of you. I have seen some of you grow in stature, grow in knowledge, even physically grow. Some of you are taller than the other, and look up to you, and I'm proud of you for that. That is, you need to tell your girls, you need to uphold them. Tell them that you love them, because what is going on out there? Anybody comes and show them that perfection, and what happens to them? They go on and do it. So please take your role responsibly. And I want the daddies to stand. So daddies stand. And you are apologizing. It's COVID. We could not hold all of you. So let's take our daddies, the men. I appreciate you. I thank you for riding with us. And I want you to continue to ride with our girls. They are the future generation. So thank you guys. And we appreciate you. So to my parents, guys, you can sit. So to my parents, for the tremendous support that you continue to give us. Yes. May God bless you. May your powers never be empty. May he enlarge your host, and just like your head did, may he keep your hand, his hand upon you and your family. And may whatever you do, you succeed. And every day, we all have to account. God is going to ask you. I gave you those beautiful gems. How did you guide them? How did you shepherd them? So take your responsibility seriously. It's not for the day only. So you can go there to the secondary school, begin to save your money. And build you too. Don't waste your parents' money. It's an investment. And it's a love investment for the future. So I want to thank my parish priest and manager, our school supervisor, who should be here shortly, our guidance officer, social worker. So Ms. Kamakala is here, and Ms. Reese is here, nice to see you. We have an alumnus, our vice principal who retired last year, Mr. Gale. So I'd like to give all of you a round of applause. I want to thank my teachers, all the ancillary workers. I want to thank all of you, my parents, my girls, and their parents, tremendous support. So I look forward to hear great things, only great things. And great things happen when God leads us with us. Great and beautiful, wonderful things. So let God mix with us. Okay? So as we move forward, be disciplined. Have your plans. Carry out those plans. Trust and believe. And sometimes what you plan to do will plan something else. And you need to redirect our focus. So as Mother Teresa says, life is an opportunity. Benefit from it. Life is beautiful. Admire it. Life is a dream. Realize it. And just remember, change is a natural part of life. So thank you.
A time for looking back on lessons. and congratulates all members of the Arima Girls R.C. family, especially the graduating class of 2022. We wish you all the best going forward. Girls, see your success. Plan it. Act on it. Put in the work. Trust God. And believe in the many blessings He has for you. Congratulations again. Thank you.
Thank you.
out your training secondary school and later on in life to God be the glory. Can I hear you say that one more time?
To God be the glory.
But you know, say it again. Let it really resonate within your heart. To God be the glory.
To God be the glory.
Amen. Okay, good. So before we go on, I'd like to give a little information. Can you talk a bit about our future speaker? Her name is Daniela Makala, and she's a former student of Arima Girls R.C. School, who has excelled academically and professed her place at St. Joseph's Convent for the state. There, she immersed herself in the school's culture by getting involved in multiple clubs, such as Pan Ensemble, cheerleading, junior choir, football, and drama group. Her outstanding character led the classmates to rely on her as their classroom treasurer, as well as a treasurer to bring their young leaders here, during which she managed to fund for their Bethlehem Girls Library project. All this, in combination with her CSEC reserves, allowed her to place in their Form 6 program. Furthermore, the position of house captain. Outside of school, Daniela volunteered as a mentor at the Eastern Study Center and a peer volunteer for the Juvenile Court Project, Court and Peer Resolution. Peer Resolution Program under the Children's Court. She also served as a member and tutor for the Major Difference Everywhere TMT organization, which allowed her to hone the passion for educational teaching. In the church community, she served as the head of water servers, a lighter, a parish promoter, and an announcer for over 4 years. Daniela's inability to write has brought her to her current roles as a literacy tutor for the NGO, the Arrow Foundation, a teacher tutor for the student community, and a private tutor for her own business, BC Energy Children's Services. Wow. So that has been very long. And I've accomplished so much so far. So we just welcome. Welcome now, welcome to our sister. Unfortunately, Daniela is ill and she can't be here with us physically, but of course she has done her meetings and spiritual here with us today and knowing that what's going on. So we have asked Mrs. Paul Jacob to present her address for her speech to you. So that's it.
Justice and put that in find and what does it mean to find? The Marina Press defines a plan as a method for achieving an end. And to plan is to have in mind an intention. Those are the simple ones. I always ask myself, if God has a plan for you, why must you plan for yourself? The answer manifests itself to me last year. All throughout my primary and secondary journey, I have had many plans that have been thwarted. And as a young child, my first ever dream job was to become a teacher, which evolved to a doctor, then an engineer, and then back to the field of education. Despite my many challenging goals, that intention to be something of myself and the world around me led me to acquire accolades and the achievements necessary to excel on my destined path. A more recent example is my journey to university. Prior to the academic, I had planned to enter university immediately after leaving secondary school. In my 4 years, I fervently acted. Suppose I am reading a dilemma, come on. But there are certain words that I'm going to use from heart, and I want you to think about those words. And the first word that she placed in bold was the word active. So after I finish, I'm going to ask you what were the words that she placed in bold. Because I fully believe these are the words she wants you to meditate on, reflect, and leave today with. So what's the first word?
Active.
I fervently acted on by my research in schools and their respective areas, chasing after teachers' recommendations, compiling my achievements, and applying to universities that suited my criteria. After all the energy and time I put into my applications, to my dismay at the time, due to changing conditions as a result of the pandemic, I wasn't able to see my plans and actions fully come to life. I was disappointed, aggravated, and confused. For those of you who pay attention to my wording, I use the word fully. Why? Although I wasn't able to attend, that process granted me moments of stillness, allowing me to pause and reflect on my life so far. Questions came up, like, what do I die first. So the next word in bold is plants. What's the next word?
Plants.
And what was the first word?
Actually.
All right. I frequently ask myself, am I doing the right thing? That's where trusting and believing in God came into play. I had to stop myself from being impulsive and straying off my path. So I have to do me to this part too. She had to go
to complete your secondary school education. When you pass your exams, no matter what school you go to, I want you to know that we expect you to do what you are best. And I know that you want to do one for yourselves, because the only way to have a good life, to prepare for the future, is to prepare now. Now, for the future, prepare now. Education is a vehicle that allows you to do that. In a changing world, we see many new careers. And many persons my age, when my child exams and my children were studying, of course, everybody wants their children to be doctors, lawyers, you know, that kind of thing. But the career paths are so many and so new now. There are many, many choices out there. Media influencers. We have people who are many persons who are entrepreneurs. A big new field that people are going into. And of course, we still have good old teaching, which is a lovely profession. I always say it's a profession with great blessings that come to you. We have medicine, we have law, we are in
Yes, thank you. Alicia Irish. Tapara Joseph. Jasara Nicole. Jazz Muhammad. Ivana Nuno. Jisha Parkinson. Thank you.
Thank you. Renee Edwards.
Just stop me. Who is my girl? Just everybody. So, I'm going to need a special on exercise.
worry. What if my parents are not calling me? What if I lose my friends and they only meet me one time? Then I'm left all lonely and worried about who I am supposed to be. He looks at me quizzically.
Yeah. #7.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yep. Good morning.
Yes, indeed, the two of them are your friends. Soon enough, all of this was grew up and lived in parallel to all our teachers, the old usher in the room. That was all we had to invent the team. We celebrated all college men as each of the classes, which we had passed through all history, the Spanish and the Mandarin games, and all kind of representation that year. We all recall being so excited to go on a field trip, and we could see plans for the cut of the radio film. We did not contain ourselves as we participated in our school's sports. We all got a chance to participate. As the other goes, the only constant is change, and change within. We will no longer to stand in one way or another. Our teachers will Mrs. Thomas Reddit and Mrs. Alexander Thomas. Mrs. Alexander Thomas was strict. She made some of us very important, and soon we found ourselves coming to do away with our infantile behaviors. We had to settle into our new world. Then, the doors of Santa Rosa R.C. opened to us, holding them open on the day, Mrs. Atai Brown, Miss Clare, and Mrs. Potato the Santa. That is when we learned the true meaning of the spirit, time waits on the new man, and time flies on the ground. For each of us, time flew, and before you knew it, the senior department of our school is where we live.
Wow.
Our teacher was Mrs. Castleman. We recall the style of dress, everything matching. In our standard street class, prior to our school meetings, we made couples, someone great and not so good. We enjoyed having the opportunity to experiment and explore the brightness of love and pleasure. Little did we know how short our experience of coming to the community. Our whole little family life as convert living forever changed. In the year 2020, the pandemic visited our schools, and soon the classes and doors of our school became digital. However, at Arima Girls R.C., we have been taught to strive for excellence in every situation. Our principal, Mrs. Russell Farrell, can be mostly do your best. We look through our anxiety, frustrations, and distractions. Standards 4 and 5, getting ready for this to be a call for much discipline. At times we look tired, looking hard, and missing our friends.
Thank you. Thank you. will talk of her. That's what I don't want about my future. Those keys that they found me wishing that companies are giving me back that I've always wanted. I wasn't quite expecting the change I came, but it's not just that it's a stress on the brain. Standards and grades is something you want. Keep your books tight, fix your hands. When it was time to put that standards to come in behind, Miss Matthew would have been standing true. Yeah, what I managed to create. Future for education, some years for education. We had this melody, standard 4 and 5. Who knew on my way could make us feel so alive? On the days when I wished I was still in the bed, cameras all keys made us all together. Essay was all we hear for 2 years. Plenty of stress and some tears. High days, low days are suffering too. Some of them days I just wanted to scream. Many lessons I've friends along the way, and here we are at this auspicious day. Some of our more years behind us and many years ago. The memory will be clear and that's for sure. So now you must pass up and check for yourself what's inside of the report and what the finish, yeah, check. Whatever we do, we will make it our best. Our remember those are will be proud, we will pass that test. As we look to the next stage, the quote on high, we won't be the story object of school fights. That's not to be done. This place was us well. The character, time, and our successful time. So, thank you, dear teachers, principal, you too. We leave here with gratitude and step in your shoes. To high school, we launch from the foundation school. Just keep us in prayer. We'll continue to live. Thank you.
So we move on, but before we, you know, performance by the way, My first point is thank you. My second point is thank you. And my third point is thank you. The first thank you goes to Almighty God, who has made it possible for all these beautiful girls to have the privilege of passing through this most beautiful school. So to God be the glory for the great things He has done in their lives. Yesterday being the solemnity of the birthday of John the Baptist, we had on us. And today being the solemnity and the feast of Sacred Heart, we are having the celebration. It's not a coincidence. It's God's grace. So thank you, God, for the life of these children. Thank you, God, for the life of these parents, grandparents, guardians. And thank you, God, for the life of these teachers and mentors. And I thank you again, the second point is thank you for bringing your children to these schools. Parents, thank you for bringing them to us. We have done our best, judging the circumstances of the pandemic. They have been here for 7 years, working day and night with these teachers. Parents, thank you for bringing them to us, and we are asking you one favor now. Please, do not stop. Take on the good works. The teachers will not be here again to see them every day. But now, they are secondary schools, they will see different teachers. These teachers will not be caring as these teachers care for them here. Parents, be more observant and make sure that the life of grace began in them. You will not stop. Remember that everyone in this praise God, they sing things of Holy Spirit God, they sing national anthem, they pray before me, they pray after me, they pray before the saints. Remember, to join with them, but they must stop praying. Yesterday, I gave them an assignment, a particular thing they sang yesterday, and I told them, sing this hymn every night, every evening of their life, and finally, thank you, teachers, for volunteering to spend your lives for these girls. Whatever good you have done in your life, God will multiply it in your own life as a teacher and in the life of your family. And thank you all for coming. May God send blessings to all of you as when we go. God go with you, and may the goodness of God never depart from your lives, the lives of your families. This is our gratitude to Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. girls, please, please, your parents.
God is your support and your strength. Okay, so
Thanks, Mr. Priscilla McGill. Please stand forward.
Thank you. graduation day 2022. Thank you. To Ms. Daniela Mancolon, past student of our school, Arima Girls R.C. In her absence, we say thank you, Ms. Mancolon, please extend it, for your words of inspiration. They will keep us as we and graduates plan, act, trust, and lead. They are the words, the words that will guide us, not only to be the best that we can possibly do for now and for the future. To Ms. Craig Moses, for your spoken words, we say to you, yes, we are strong and we are about to do everything we already have. Thank you.
Instead, says James to you, you should leave space for God.
God changes daily. Lord's will, we will live and do this as it is. So I want you to remember that change is inevitable and is expected. And as usual, what are the forwards? How do I move forwards? Well, you don't say prayer, but this is what I understand. What it is you are saying. So let's say that again. What was it? First thing?
Thank you.
take your class for